I just released a video where I ranked all of the farm layouts in Stardew Valley, and that video gave me a very bad idea. How difficult can I make the wilderness farm? Just take a look at this clip here. It is absolute chaos. There are tons of enemies. They are moving at incredible speed, do tons of damage, and it is just outright chaos. And how did I get to this? Alrighty, let's get started. As you know, on the wilderness farm, enemies will spawn at night and attack the player. Since in the early game, your character is quite weak, the enemies actually scale in power based on your combat level. So, in the early game, the enemies are really not that hard to deal with. So I boosted up my combat level to level 10 to see how much harder the enemies will be when I am maxed out on my combat level. The enemies are definitely much harder to defeat now, especially since I have a very, very low level sword, and these bats just seem to have quite a bit of health, and they are doing a lot of damage. But there is one major problem. Enemies only spawn at night, meaning you'll be completely safe during the day, which isn't really what I was going for. So I downloaded a mod that will cause enemies to spawn randomly around the player every 10 minutes. By default, there is a 1% chance that an enemy would spawn around the player every 10 in-game minutes. 1% was just not doing it for me. So naturally, I immediately changed it to 15%. It took a while, but after a few in-game hours, there were quite a few enemies running around on my farm. I think this mod I downloaded spawns enemies that would not usually spawn on the wilderness farm, because this was already much more difficult than those few bats I fought earlier. Most of the enemies weren't much of a problem, but the shadow brutes were proving to be the most difficult enemies to deal with. I could quite easily kite the other enemies, but the shadow brutes were extremely fast. Like, extremely fast. But I still managed to defeat enemies and survive, even though I only have this extremely weak weapon, so this is just not difficult enough. The only problems I had were the shadow brutes, but nothing I couldn't handle. And if I had a better weapon, this would be way too easy. So naturally, I just had to make it more difficult. The enemies that spawn do scale with your combat level, and I am currently at combat level 10, meaning the enemies won't get any harder unless I use a mod to extend the maximum level of my skills. And that is exactly what I did. This mod allows you to level up your skills all the way to level 100. So let's see how the enemies are at level 100 combat. And it seems that they are doing some crazy fast, erratic movements, zooming around uncontrollably, making it very, very hard to actually hit them, and at the same time doing way too much damage to me. I died quite quickly before there were even many enemies to fight. Maybe I got unlucky. Let me try again. Maybe I just got unlucky the first time. They can't be that difficult, right? Well, it seems that a single skeleton is more than enough to defeat me. Okay, I'll admit it, it's really difficult, but they have an unfair advantage. I mean, I have no boots, rings, and a very weak sword. It's time for a training arc. Let's get started with a galaxy sword. Bring a prismatic shard to this spot in the desert and you'll get a galaxy sword. This should be a huge upgrade already. But no, that is not enough. You saw how hard those monsters were. It's time to upgrade our galaxy sword into the fabled sword of legend, the Infinity Blade. 3 galaxy souls and 120 cinder shards later, this should definitely help out a ton. It seems that most of the enemies are ghosts and skeletons. So to make life a little bit easier, we should enchant our Infinity Blade. The Crusader enchant is perfect for this because it will increase my damage to skeletons, mummies, and ghosts by 50%. I will have to sacrifice a few prismatic shards, but it will definitely be worth it. Next up, some rings. Nothing fancy. Let's go with 2 iridium bands combined with a warrior ring to give me bonus damage after I defeat an enemy. and a regular ruby ring for an extra 10% bonus to my overall damage. Doing this without rings was just a huge mistake. We should probably also enhance our infinity blade with some rubies. Every extra bit of damage should help. And lastly, let's use the dragon scale boots because they give the highest defense bonus out of any of the other boots in the game. Let's see how much of a difference this training arc has made. Something very strange happened. I left my house and then these rock crabs just kept smashing right into me, dealing tons of damage. I was unable to hit them back, meaning I could not avoid the damage. I pretty much died immediately, which was not at all what I was expecting. I mean, I have dragon scale boots after all, but something even stranger happened. When my character miraculously came back from the dead, my health bar suddenly became really huge. Like extremely huge. I think I had close to 6,000 health, which was unexpected. This is probably due to my new combat level being at 100, as each level in combat will slightly increase your maximum health by a tiny bit. For some reason, my health did not update until I died. This is probably a bug, and bugs are to be expected when playing around with mods. I just wonder why I decided to update now and not earlier. After my health updated accordingly, with all of these weapons, rings, and boots, the enemies weren't that tough to deal with anymore. I could defeat enemies. It wasn't easy. They were really tanky. They did a lot of damage to me, and there were so many enemies, but I still defeated them. How the spawning monster mod works is every 10 minutes in the game, there will be a chance that an enemy will spawn close to the player. I initially had it set to 15%, but my character was having no problem with these enemies. So I changed it all the way up to 100%. So yeah, there were more enemies spawning on my farm within a few in-game hours than I have ever seen after an entire Skull Cavern run. But since most of the enemies are slimes, skeletons, and ghosts, it wasn't too bad. Imagine if this mod could allow royal serpents to spawn randomly around the player. That would make this much, much more difficult. This mod will also spawn enemies anywhere in the world of Stardew Valley. Here I was walking Shane home and protecting him from monsters. So yeah, using this mod is quite risky. You probably won't be able to play the game in a normal way at all. If you have been enjoying this video so far, please do consider subscribing. It helps me out a ton and it's completely free. Alrighty, back onto the video. Good luck chopping down a tree with hordes of monsters chasing you at unrealistic speeds. And just imagine trying to fish with ghosts disturbing you. There is a reason why the normal wilderness farm only spawns enemies at night and why it doesn't have that many monsters. The mod I used is called Level Extender. It will increase the maximum possible level of all your skills to 100. There are some benefits to this and it definitely adds some fun grind potential. You can also use some simple commands to set a particular skill to a certain level. This same mod will allow enemies to spawn randomly around the player. There are also commands to set the spawn rate. You can find the link to the mod in the description below. Thank you so much for watching this video. It was a lot of fun to experiment and play around with the wilderness farm, but it's definitely not sustainable. If you like this video, you should check this one out too. It's so good, especially that part at the end. So explosive. But for now, I will see you in the next video.